What's up guys, Sal here. So there's absolutely no doubt that the Galaxy S10 will be the most powerful smartphone ever released. And now we have some benchmark leaks to kind of support that claim. The Exynos 9820 powered Galaxy S10 has been benchmarked on AnTuTu with a score of 325,076, which is higher than the Huawei's latest 7nm chip Kirin 980 on the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, but is lower than the Snapdragon 855 that came away with a score of 362,292. That's perhaps not surprising when you consider that in some ways, the Snapdragon 855 seems to be a more advanced chip because it's a 7nm chip, making it smaller and likely more efficient than the 8nm Exynos 9820. But like I've said multiple times in the past, it's dumb to say which processor is better just based on these stupid benchmarks alone. These never translate to real-world performance. I can assure you, you'll not even notice the performance difference in real life. Benchmark is only used how can the phone handle really demanding apps and heavy games, not on general performance. Back then, like 3 or 4 years ago, benchmark was still used to measure general performance, but starting 2014 I guess, the hardware can keep up with Android demand easily in daily usage, so it's not wise to use benchmark to measure what a phone can do in daily tasks. Arguing over synthetic benchmark scores is like arguing over which car has a lower coefficient of drag. To someone holding a phone in their hand, they aren't really gonna care or know if the one they have has a slightly higher or lower AnTuTu score than the phone next to them. All they care about is how well the phone runs, and that is something that doesn't really translate into any of these benchmarks, so don't pay much attention to these. So new reports say that Samsung has finalized the camera specs on all the variants of the Galaxy S10. For those of you who don't know, the Galaxy S10 Lite will have a single rear camera, the S10 will have two, the S10 Plus will have three, and the 5G variant of the S10 will have four rear cameras. These reports say the camera performance has also been greatly improved compared to last year. I don't think Samsung's flagship camera performance has been a flaw in the eyes of anyone, so really excited to see how they improved what is already considered good. Rest assured, I'm gonna cover each and every Galaxy S10 update, so please consider subscribing if you haven't already. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.